Good morning, everyone. How you all? I hope you have done the homework which I have assigned yesterday. And yesterday we have finished with exercise 2.3. Now, today we'll be starting the new exercise, that is exercise 2.5. Sorry, 2.4. So let's start exercise 2.4. Exercise 2.4. In this exercise, we have to estimate the sum to the nearest 10, 100 or 1000. You must be remember about the round off that we have done. Round off to the nearest 10, round off to the nearest 100, round off to the nearest 1000. If you remember that, the way we have to round off, we used to round off, we have to do the round off in these questions also. Before starting these questions, let me recall those round off that we have done. Round off to the nearest 10. In this case, we need to check the ones place. If the ones place is less than 5, then we just need not to add 1 to the tens place. We simply write down the tens place or 100 place as it is, and the digit at ones place will become 0. If I talk about 54, that the ones place is 4, which is less than 5, so we simply write down 50. We have made 4 as 0 and 5 will remain same. If suppose the example I'll take is 67. Now the digit at ones place is 7, that means which is greater than 5. If the digit at ones place is greater than 5 or equals to 5, we will add 1 to the 10's place and the 1's place will become 0. As I have taken the number 57, so 7 is greater than 5. That means we will add 1 to the digit 5. That is, 5 will become 6 and 7 will become 0. So the number 57 is rounded to 60. This is round off to the nearest 10. Now if we'll talk about nearest 100, then we need to check the digit at tens place. That means if suppose the digit at tens place is greater than or equals to 5, then we'll be rounding off that number by adding 1 to which place? 1 to 1000 place, and then the number will be, you suppose, I'll take the example, 5, 6, 7. 5, 6, 7. Now, we have to check the tens place. Tens place is 6. So, that means, what we'll be doing? We'll be adding 1 to the 100 place, that is 5. So, 5 ban jayega aapka 6, aur jo baaki ki places bach gaye, that will be 0, 0. That is round off to the nearest 100. And if we talk about round off to the nearest 1000, in that case we need to check 100 place. If 100 place is less than 5 or greater than 5, if less than 5 we will not make any changes, we will just make the tens place, ones place and 100 place 000. And if suppose it's greater than 5, the digit at 100 place, then we need to make 100 place, tens place and ones place 000, but we'll add 1 to the 1000 place. So this is round off to the nearest 1000. Now let's start this question. I hope you must have recalled this round off. Let's start this question. Question 1, 59 plus 24. We have to estimate the sum to the nearest 10 and compare it with the actual sum. Means हमें पहले तो estimation निकालना है इन दोनों का, इन दोनों number का हम estimate करेंगे. That means 59 आपका estimate जब हम करेंगे to the nearest 10, that means we will check ones place. Here you can see the ones place is 9, which is greater than 5. So what we have to do, we have to add plus 1 to the digit at tens place. That means 5 आपका बन जाएगा 6 and 9 will become 0. So 59 is rounded to which number? That is 60. Same way we have to do the round off of 24. As you can see, 4 at ones place, the digit is 4. So we need to round off. We need not to add 1. because it is less than 4, less than 5. So that means 24 is rounded to which number? It is 20. Ones place of 0 ban jayega aur baki as it is rahega. So the 24 is rounded to 20. Now we'll find out the estimate sum. मतलब जो हमने round off करके जो number निकाला है, उनका हम sum निकालेंगे, plus करेंगे. That means 60 and 20 is a round off of the particular numbers. So we'll be estimating the sum of these. We will do addition, the sum. We'll find out the sum of these two. So 60 plus 20 is what? 80. So this is an estimate sum. Now if you talk about actual sum means जो already number given है उसको plus करना. मतलब 59 plus 24 को हमें plus करना है. So let's do addition of that. 9 plus 4 is what? 13. So 1 on the top, carry over. And then 5 plus 2 7, 7 plus 1 8. So the actual sum is 83. Now you can see the estimate sum and actual sum is very close to each other. It is 80 and it is 83. So we have to write down because we have to compare also these two sum. So that means we have to write down this line that estimate sum is very close to actual sum. By this line we understand the comparison between the actual and the estimate sum. So we need to write down this line. Now let's move to the another part. Here in this slide you can see we have done C and E part. Let's start with the C part first. It's 505 plus 19. So first work what we have to do is we have to round off these two numbers. Let's start from 505. As we have to round off to the nearest 10, as it is given in the question, that means we have to check 1's place. Here the 1's place is 5, which is equals to 5. So that means we will be adding 1 to the 10's place. As we have done, 505 mein aapka 10's place is 0. 0 mein humne 1 add kar dena, that will become 0 will become 1. And the 5 at 1's place will become 0. And the rest the number, that is at 100 place, 5 at 100 place will remain the same. So this shows that 505 is rounded to which number? 510. Same, we have to round off the 19 number. As you can see, 9 at 1's place is greater than 5. So we'll be adding 1 to the 10's place. That means 1 mein humne agar plus 1 kiya, so it will become 2. And the digit at 1's place will remain the same, that is 0. So will become 0 instead of 9. So the 19 is rounded to which number? 20. Now once we have done the round off, now we need to find out the estimate sum and the actual sum. You can see side mein maine kiya hai. I have done estimate sum first. Estimate sum matlab jo humne round off karke number nikala hai uska sum nikalenge. It is 5, 10 and 20. We need to add them. When we add them the answer become 530. Now we need to compare with the actual sum, so for that we have to find out the actual sum as well. Now the actual sum is 505 and 19. So we will be adding those two numbers. So 5 plus 9 is what? 14. So 1 on the top and 1 plus 1 is 2 and 2 plus 0 is again 2 and 5 as it is. So the number or the sum of the actual sum is 524. That means this is closer, it is very close to actual sum, estimate sum. Yes, so we have to write down this line, estimated sum is very close to actual sum. This you need to write down this line, otherwise your marks will be deducted. Because it's given that you have to compare the actual sum with estimated sum. Now let's move to the E part. It is 314 plus 709. 314 plus 709, let's start with the 314 first. We have to round off this number. You can see at 1 split 4, so that means we need not to make any changes as we need not to do any addition of 1 to the next number, next digit. That means 4 only becomes 0 and rest places will remain the same. That means 314 is rounded to which number? That is 310. Now if we talk about the next digit, next number, that is 709, let's do round off of this. We have to see the 1's place, the 1's place is 9. So that means we need to add 1 to the 10's place. So that means 0 will become 1 and 9 will become 0. So the number will become 709 is rounded to which number? It is 710. This is the number 709 is rounded to 710. That means if we talk about the estimated sum and actual sum, let's first of all find out the estimated sum which we have which we need to, in this case we have to add the numbers that we have already round off. That means 310 and next is 710. So we need to add them. Let's add them. 0 plus 0 is what? 0. 7 plus, 1 plus 1 is 2. 3 plus 7 is 10. So that means estimated sum is 1020. Now if you talk about the actual sum is 314 plus 709. So if we have to add it, 9 plus 4 is what? 13. So 3 and 1 on the top. 1 plus 1 is 2 and 7 plus 3 is 10. So the number is 1023. So you can see that estimated sum is very close to the actual sum. So we have to write down this line that estimated sum is very close to the actual sum. So like this we have to do this question. I hope you have cleared with how to find out the estimated sum and actual sum. Okay, now let's move to the next question, question 2. Question 2, estimate the sum to the nearest 100 and compare it with the actual sum. Now in the question 1, you have seen that we have find out the estimate to the nearest ones. Nearest tens. Now in this case, in question 2, we have to find out the estimate to the nearest 100. That means for the nearest 100, we need to check which place? Tens place. So the first question, the A part. It is 277 plus 232. We have to do this question the same way we have done the question 1. The difference is only the estimation. In the question 1, we have to find out the estimate to the nearest tens. And here we need to find out the estimate to the nearest 100. The only difference is that. Rest, everything is same. Now, we start with the 277. Now, 277, we have to check the tens place. And the tens place is 7, which is greater than 5. That means we need to add 1 to which place? 100 place. And the rest of the digit, that is 1's place and 10's place, will become 0, 0. So, the 277 is what we is rounded to, which number? 300. Because 2 will become 3, because we have add 1 to the number 2. And rest of the places, that is 10's and 1's place, will become 0, 0. So, 277 is rounded to 300. Now, if we talk about 232, now you can see the digit at 10's place is 3, which is less than 5. So which shows that we need not to do any addition. 1 nahi hum add karenge. That means 232 is rounded to which number? 200. Because we have not made any changes at 100 place. 2 as it is hi aa gaya. Or 10's or 1's place kya ban gaya aapka? 0. So it is rounded to 200. Now once we have find out the round off, now we need to find out the estimate sum and the actual sum. Estimated sum is like one number is 300 and another number is 200. So when we add both the numbers, then we get the 500. So that means estimated sum is 500. Now in the same way, if I'll find out the actual sum is that the number is 277 and 232. We need to add them. When we add them, the answer is 509. As you can see, 7 plus 2 is 9. And 7 plus 3 is what? 10. 10 and 1 on the top. And 2 plus 2, 4 and 1, 5. So the actual sum is 509. So this shows that estimated sum is very much close to actual sum. We need to write down that line. So we have written that. Same way, we have to do the C part. You can see the C part, it's 455 and 912. So in 455, the tens place is 5. So, which is equals to 5, that means we have to add 1 to the 100 place. I have done that. 4 plus 1 is what? 5. And rest of the places, that means jo aapka tens and ones place hai, wo aapka ho gaya 0, 0. So, this shows that 455 is rounded to which number? 500. That means that 455 is rounded to 500. Now, in the same way, if we talk about 912, in 912, here the digit at tens place is 1, which is less than 5. That means we need not to add 1 to the 100 place. So the number will become, that means 912 is rounded to 900. So 912 is rounded to 900. So this means that estimated sum is, first we need to add them. The estimated sum 500 and 900. because these are the estimate numbers that we get while rounding off. So 500 or 900 को जब हम plus करेंगे the answer क्या आएगा 1400. Now let's find out the actual sum. Actual sum means that we have to add 555 plus 912. When we add them, what we find out? Let's add them. 5 plus 2 is what? 7. And 5 plus 1 is what? 6. And 9 plus 4 is what? 13. So the number is 1367. So which is close to actual sum, which is close to estimated sum. That means estimated sum is close to actual sum. So that's how you have to do this question. Now let's do the another part, E part of this question in the next slide. Now let's start the another part, that is E part. It is 922 plus 877. First of all, let's find out the round off. So we'll take with the 922. As 922, we have to see the tens place, that is 2. Tens place is 2, which is less than 5. That means we'll not be making any changes at 100 place. So 922 is rounded to which number? 900. And then if you talk about 877, the digit at tens place is 7, which is greater than 5. That means we have to add 1 to the 100 place. That means 8 will become 9, and rest of the places, that is 7, 7, tens and ones place, it will be 0, 0. So 877 is rounded to which number? 900. Now we have rounded off both the numbers. Now we need to find out the estimate sum. Estimate sum and the actual sum. Estimate sum means that we have to add which two numbers? 900 and 900. Yes, that means 900 plus 900 is what? 1800. Now if we talk about actual sum, that means we have to add 922 and 877. Let's add that. You can see 7 plus 2 is what? 9. Again, 7 plus 2 is what? 9. And 9 plus 8 is what? 17. So this shows that the actual sum is 1799, which is very much close to estimated sum. So we have to write down this line also. Estimated sum is very close to actual sum. I hope you have understood this concept about how to find out the estimated sum, whether it be nearest 10, whether it be nearest 100. Okay. Now, the next question, question 3. It is a statement sum. Listen it carefully. First of all, understand the statement, what they are saying. Sanya bought a mobile phone for rupees 23,460. सान्या एक मोबाइल फ़ोन लाई है जिसकी कॉस्ट है आपकी 23,460 और एक एलईडी टीवी लाई है जिसकी कॉस्ट है 34,890. नाउ एस्टीमेट द टोटल मनी स्पेंड बाय हर इन बाइंग द टू आइटम्स. हमें एस्टीमेट करना है टोटल मनी जो उसने खर्च किए हैं इन दोनों आइटम्स को खरीदने के लिए. प्लीज़ बी केयरफुल, द वर्ड एस्टीमेट हैज़ बीन रिटन इन दिस. So this is a statement sum. The way you do the statement sum, we have to do like that only. But in this case, as it's written estimate, so we have to estimate the amount which has been given to you. Here, now you can see the solution how I have written in this type of question what we have to do. It is here we just need an estimate and not the exact number. Hame estimate chahiye, exact number isme nahi chahiye. So it would be suitable to the nearest 1000 and then add them. इसका मतलब अगर हमें इसमें क्या करना पड़ेगा, इसे राउंड ऑफ करना पड़ेगा टू द नियरेस्ट 1000 और फिर हमें क्या करना है, ऐड करना है. यू कैन सी, यू विल से दैट मैम हमें कैसे पता चलेगा कि दैट वी हैव टू राउंड ऑफ टू द नियरेस्ट 10, 100 और 1000 एज इट्स नॉट गिवन इन दिस स्टेटमेंट. प्लीज इंश्योर दैट वेन एवर वी आर हैविंग टू डिजिट नंबर, वेन एवर वी आर हैविंग टू डिजिट नंबर और वन डिजिट नंबर, वी ऑलवेज राउंड ऑफ टू द नियरेस्ट 10. एंड इफ वी टॉक अबाउट, इफ सपोज वी हैव थ्री डिजिट नंबर, ऑलवेज राउंड ऑफ टू द नियरेस्ट वट 100. एंड इफ वी हैव फोर डिजिट नंबर और मोर देन फोर डिजिट नंबर, देन वी नीड टू राउंड ऑफ टू द नियरेस्ट 1000. सो यू कैन सी हेयर इट इज मोर देन फोर डिजिट नंबर. So that means we'll be rounding off to the nearest 1000. So if we have one digit or two digit, nearest, आप round off करेंगे nearest 10.
एंड अगर आपका थ्री डिजिट नंबर है देन इट्स नियरेस्ट 100, और अगर आपका फोर या फोर से ज़्यादा है वी विल बी डूइंग नियरेस्ट 1000. सो इन दिस केस वी विल बी डूइंग नियरेस्ट 1000. इफ़ यू नीड टू फाइंड आउट द नियरेस्ट 1000, दैट मीन्स वी नीड टू चेक विच प्लेस, 100 प्लेस. नाउ लेट्स सी द 100 प्लेस. एज यू कैन सी इट इज 23,460. सो लेट्स फाइंड आउट द नियरेस्ट 1000 ऑफ दिस नंबर, विच मीन्स दैट इन नियरेस्ट, इफ यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट द नियरेस्ट 1000, इन दैट केस वी नीड टू चेक द 100 प्लेस. So you can see the 100 place, 100 place is 4 here, which is less than 5. That means we need not to do any changes at the 10,000 place. आपको पता है अगर हम 100 place check कर रहे हैं, I'll repeat it again. 23,460 है, हम check करते हैं इसमें 100 place. 100 place is 4, अगर less than 5 है, तो दैट मीन्स वी विल नॉट मेक एनी चेंजेस एट 1000 प्लेस. हम 1 at 1000 प्लेस पे नहीं करेंगे, इसमें हम कोई चेंजेस नहीं करेंगे, हम एज इट इज़ वो प्लेस एज इट इज़ लिखेंगे. सो वॉट वी हैव डन हेयर, अब आपका 100 प्लेस पे 4 है, दैट मीन्स वी विल मेक 100 प्लेस, 10th प्लेस एंड 1th प्लेस विल बिकम 000, एंड द रेस्ट ऑफ द प्लेसेज दैट इज 1000 एंड 10,000 प्लेस विल बी एज इट इज़ ओनली. दैट मीन्स देयर विल बी नो चेंजेस इन दैट. सो 23 विल बिकम 23 ओनली. So this shows that ₹23,460 is rounded off to ₹23,000. Same you can see, it's ₹34,890. Now if we talk about 100 place, the 100 place is 8, which is greater than 5. That means we'll add 1 to which number, which place? 1000 place, that is 4. 4 will become 5, and rest of the places, jo 4 ke baad hai, that means 100, 10s and 1s place will be become 00, and the digit at 10,000 place will remain same, that is 3 only. So 34,890 is rounded off to which number? 35,000. So here we first have find out the round off of these particular numbers nearest 1000 say. I hope you have understood the round off. We have already done it before. So, in this type of question, we ensure that hum round off pehle karenge, as we have done here. Now, once we have find out the round off, find out the estimated sum and the actual sum. Estimated sum, you can see, estimated sum, it's 23,000 and 35,000. We need to add them. The answer after adding that estimated sum will be 58,000. Now, if we talk about actual sum is 23,460 and 34,890. Let's add them. If we add them, 0 plus 0 is what? 0. And if we talk about 9 plus 6, it is 5 and 1 on the top. 1 plus 4 is what? 5. 5 plus 8 is what? 13. So, 3 here and 1 on the top. So, 3 plus 1 is 4. 4 plus 4 is 8. And then 3 plus 2 is 5. So it is 58,350. Now you can see the estimated money spent on buying two items is ₹58,000, as we have asked to, and which is close to actual sum. Kya hai wo? Wo kiske equal hai? It is close to which sum? That is actual sum. That's how you have to do the estimated type of statements. I hope you have understood this statement. So let us start. Now we have finished this chapter. Now we'll be wrapping up with the following points as I've written here. These are the points that we have covered in this chapter. The first point that we have is addition with regrouping. Addition with regrouping, what does it mean? That we have done the addition with the carryovers. Humne carryovers ke saath addition isme kiya hai. Addition with regrouping. Now, if addition without regrouping, we have not done any carryovers in this. We have just simply added. Add the numbers. Then, next topic is properties of addition. We have done the properties of addition. We have done total 4 properties of addition. First is order of numbers. What does it mean? That the sum of 2 numbers remain the same if we change the order of the number. किसी भी दो numbers का अगर हम sum करते हैं, sum same रहेगा. Even if we change the order, अगर हम उसको ऊपर नीचे भी कर देते हैं, numbers change कर देते हैं उनके order, तब भी answer आपका same ही रहेगा. The second property is grouping of the numbers. Grouping of the numbers is, if suppose we are adding three numbers, and if we are grouping them, like if we are adding first two number first, and then after, once we add the first two number and whatever the answer is coming, we are adding that answer with the third number, then the answer what we get is equal to, if we change the orders, that means अगर पहले हमने first two numbers को add किया है और फिर उसके answer को third number से add किया है, और अगर हम इसमें ऐसे भी कर देते हैं कि अगर हम पहले first number लेते हैं and then third number लेते हैं, पहले उन दोनों को add करते हैं और उसके answer को हम second number से add करते हैं, तब भी आपका answer जो sum निकलेगा वो same रहेगा. So that means when we are grouping the numbers, even then also we are getting the same answer. Now the third property, adding zero to a number. Whenever we add zero to any number, the answer will be the same. And then fourth property, adding one to a number. When we are adding one to any number, we are getting the successor of that number. So this is the fourth property of addition. Now the next point is addition in real life. Addition in real life means that we are doing some addition in real life also. That means if we are going to buy things, we are doing what? We are doing addition in that also. So in the real life, in the practical form of also, we are doing addition. That we have talked about in this, we have talked about the statement sums. Now then as we have estimated sums, humne round off karke estimating sums bhi nikale hain. In the next point, we have done those things we have covered in. So here we come to an end of this chapter. Now we are left with workout and the mental maths that we'll be doing tomorrow. So you just take out, note down the homework which I am giving for today. Homework question 1. Estimate the sum to the nearest 10 and compare it with actual sum. It's A part, B part and C part. We have three parts in this question 1. Now question 2. Estimate the sum to the nearest 100 and compare it with actual sum. A part, B part and C part. I hope you all will do the homework. Thank you.